My name is Bob Wolves, and I'm the executive director of the Harry S. Truman Little White House in Key West, Florida. The Little White House itself is 9,000 square feet. Without any doubt, this is one of the most historic spots in South Florida, in that seven American presidents have used it. Our structure was built in 1890 as Navy housing, but it rapidly became used by a number of presidents, President Taft, President Roosevelt. Harry Truman used it the most, so he gets his name on it forever. Currently, we are very honored to have a collection of presidential cartoons. The president himself collected cartoons, and as most of us know, cartoons can either support a cause or they can go against it. And Harry Truman enjoyed the press. He had a good relationship with the press most of the time, but political cartoons being what they are, you could almost erase any president's name and insert the current president and it would still apply. The exhibit that we're running right now is all Harry Truman cartoons, although the earliest ones go clear back to the time of Thomas Jefferson. So political cartoons have been around for a long time in the United States. We have currently a free exhibit of presidential cartoons that begin when President Truman became president in April of 1945, and they continue through his presidency into his campaigning for Adlai Stevenson in the 1952 campaign, as well as even the 1956 campaign. So Harry Truman had covered a wide span of time and was often the subject of political cartoons. We have several of the original cartoons. Most of them were individually drawn by various artists. And so each one captured their own vision of what they could take a poke at the president or at the opposition party. Sometimes the cartoonists would pick back and forth between the two parties. So no one was sacred in this endeavor. One of the subjects that always seems to come up, and it doesn't matter who the president is that the president just isn't spending enough time in Washington. We need that guy to be there 24/7 because we're paying his salary. And it certainly applied to President Truman. In 1953, they published a cartoon with his head buried in the sand, like he didn't have a clue what was going on. He's just hiding out in Key West, Florida. One of my favorite pieces of history was on March 12th of 1947. England was pulling out of the Mediterranean. Greece and Turkey were about to fall to communist rebels. And so President Truman announced to the Congress what is known as the Truman Doctrine. And what it said is that America will defend freedom-loving people no matter where they are in the world. The day after that announcement to Congress, the president flew to Key West, and the full impact of that hit Key West. Now, ironically, not everyone agreed with the president, and so they brought out a cartoon showing America's resources flowing overseas in foreign aid to Greece and Turkey and to Chiang Kai-shek and to Peron in Argentina. So just like today, the American people love to complain. President loved political cartoons himself. He collected them. And so he invited all the different cartoonists of the major newspapers to sketch the president at the White House. And so each one has their own version of what Harry looked like. This one is referring to the fact that following World War II, there was great inflation in the United States, something we've not seen for a long time, which is a good thing. And so the Congress had passed price controls. And so in this particular cartoon, they're making political commentary on the control of prices. And basically, they're not very happy with the fact that Congress is trying to set prices on everything from refrigerators to snow tires. We always invite people to come and see the Little White House, of course. The Little White House is honored to be a property of the state of Florida. The governor and cabinet are our landlords. And so we invite the citizens of South Florida to come and see a very special place called the Truman Little White House.